So we will see this experiment, the first experiment in the part B, that is interface a simple toggle switch to 8051 and write an assembly level program to generate an interrupt which switches on the LED. So there are two conditions. So we are connecting one switch to a port pin, and we are using interrupt here. So once the switch is pressed, there are two cases. One case is LED should be always on as long as the switch is pressed. Second case is LED should on for some time, then switch off if the switch is pressed. So there are two conditions. We will see today how to use multisim alone to write your code and create the circuit and build the code, everything under this multisim environment itself. First, we will create the circuit. This is a circuit which I am going to use it. 8051 microcontroller with the basic connections, the ground, the power supply, and I am using INT1 interrupt, where the switch which is connected to interrupt 1, P3.3, pin number 13, INT1. Okay, so when the switch is pressed, this pin number 13 will be grounded. When it is not pressed, it will be high. Since INT1 is active low, if a 0 comes in pin number 13, the interrupt will be enabled. Okay, so this is the circuit of the switch, and I am connecting my LED to P2.0. If you see the LED, I am using an active low logic, whereas if this P2.0, if it is 0, then the LED will glow. So how this logic works is one side, the positive side of the LED is connected to VCC and negative side of the LED is connected to P2.0, and we are using some filter capacitor and resistance to the ground. So the moment a 0 comes in pin number 21, then this LED will glow, and if pin number 21 is high, then LED will be off. How do we build the circuit? I will take you to the multisim now. I will first place the microcontroller. So go to the MCU, place MCU, select the microcontroller 8051 and place it. It will ask for a workspace name. You can give any name. So I will use LED2 here and then press next. It will ask whether we need to use a standard project type. There are two types here, standard or external. If we are programming in or external IDE like Keil Microsoft or Android, then we can use this external hex file. But now, today I am going to show you how to use a standard interfacing. So I will take standard, and I am going to use assembly language today. So I will take assembly. I need to give project name here. That is, I will use the same name, that is workspace name, that is LED2. Then I will press next. It will create by itself one ASM file here inside this environment. So I will leave it like that. Press finish. In this, if you expand this design, under this LED2 project, you can see one ASM appearing here. Okay, so when you double click here, you can paste your, or you can type your code here itself. Okay, you can just insert your code here. So we will come back to this. So now what else I need to use? I need to use power supply, then ground, then one switch, 10K resistor, 1K resistor, one LED, one microfarad capacitor. Okay, so let me place all these components together and then we will make the connections ready. First, I will go to the power supply, power sources, VCC, fine. I will keep somewhere here near to 40, then ground. Okay, somewhere near to the ground session. Okay, then as I seen, I need a switch, right? So I will go to switches, are they available, or the basics, there is a switch here. Okay, I will use a simple DAP switch. I will take it here, place it here, then I will use a resistor, 10K resistor is what is shown there, 10K. Yes, I will take that resistor, place it here. Then I need a 1K resistor also. I will use it. You can use a 47K or 1K or 10K, doesn't matter. Then I need a capacitor. I am using 1 microfarad capacitor. So I select the capacitor, then I select 1 mu, right? Yeah. So 1 microfarad capacitor. I will have to use anything else. One LED I need to use. Okay, fine. So LED green is there, yellow is there, red is there. Let me use this green LED. Okay. So I placed all the components. So I will close it, and now I will make the connections ready. Ground has to be grounded, VCC to VCC, and this switch, I will make it, I will rotate by pressing Ctrl R. I will keep it here. This resistor also I will rotate once so that it be in one line. And what I will do is, this one side of this switch I am connecting to the ground, and when the switch is pressed, the ground should come to INT1. So I will connect the other side of the switch to INT1, and when the switch is not pressed, this INT1 should be connected to VCC. So I will take this to VCC through this resistor. Okay, that's a basic switch connections done. Okay, my input side of the circuit is ready. The switch is connected to the INT1. So now I will connect the output, the LED. I am going to connect this LED to P2.0. So what I will do is, the positive side of the LED I will connect to VCC, and then the negative side of the LED I need to connect to P2.0, and I will also give a grounding through resistor. This is the usual practice we will do, so that the excess current will get passed through the ground through the resistor. Okay, I will use this 1 microfarad to filter out any kind of noise. I will connect it here and connect that to the ground across this pin. Okay, so my basic circuit is ready now. Now we will go to the programming part, main.asm. So when you double click there, you will get into the program space. So there I will just type the program here. So already I typed this program. So so once you type this program, what next you have to do is you need to save it. Okay, it's already saved in the name of main.asm. So I will save it here. Okay, so now I will explain you the code of this program. So what we are doing is, we need to write a program in order to turn on the LED. One program is, the LED should be on when the switch is pressed, and the switch is connected to external interrupt. Okay, so we are using interrupt concept here. Make sure that the main program is written in the reset location, that is 0000. But since we are going to use this interrupt, external interrupt, and the external interrupt is residing, it has to, that interrupt service routine should be residing in a particular memory location. You know, INT1's vector, interrupt vector is 013. Okay, 13 is the location where interrupt 1 interrupt service routine to be returned. So I am reserving this 0013 for the interrupt service routine. So this highlighted portion is the ISR, interrupt service routine. So what I will do, once I restart this microcontroller, I should not come to this location. So what I am doing in the first line itself, I am skipping this area, memory, the quad memory area, I am skipping by jumping to the main. Okay, so what is this main? Main is residing in the location 30 only. Okay, so I can use either A jump or L jump. So I am using here L jump, so no problem. So once the first line is executed in the main program that is residing in the location 30, what I am writing is, I am enabling the external interrupt 1. If you look at this IE register, IE register has got the global enabled as the MSB, and LSB is for INT0, second LSB is for timer 0, the third bit is for INT1. So we are enabling the third bit and the global enabled. That means INT1 is enabled. Okay, so once you enable this interrupt, first I am making sure that LED is off. In the circuit diagram, if I give a 1 to P2.0, the LED will be off, right? So when if I wanted to turn on the LED, I need to send 0. If I need to turn off, I need to send 1. I am turning it off by sending a 1. That is that this line does. So first I am ensuring that LED is off. Okay. Then I will make sure I am waiting in this line, because I don't need to do anything in this program, right? I just wait here. I make sure that LED is off, wait here, and the moment if any interrupt comes, that is when the switch is pressed, the program execution will go to this location, that is interrupt service routine. And in this line, what we are doing, we are clearing the LED pin. So when you are clearing the LED pin, it will turn on the LED. Then we have two cases we need to analyze, right? One is that it should be, LED should be on continuously. Second case is LED should be on for a small time. So I have written a program in such a way that once you turn on the LED, it will stay there for some time and then switch it off. So I will return this interrupt, and again return interrupt will come back to this lane only. It will continue again waiting for the next interrupt. So this is the program. Once you complete this program, and the next thing is you need to make sure there are no errors in this program, right? So what I will do is I will just save this. It will save as main.asm. Then go to this MCU 8051. There is a build option here. So click on build. It will show here if there is any errors in the program. So it is showing zero errors and zero warnings. So this program is intact. You have built the circuit. Now the next step is you just go to your hardware part. So already the program is now residing in this. This program, once you run this circuit, when you press the key, LED should be on and it should be off after some time, right? So let me run this program and check whether it is working or not. You have to press yes. Okay, it is not on now. Let me turn on the switch. Yes, it is on and it is off after a delay. I am using this shortcut key A here, okay, to turn on and turn off. Yes. See, I am not connecting this anywhere. I am just using this interrupt here. The moment I enable the interrupt, this is on now. I'm pressing and releasing, and you can see it is not switching off immediately. It will switch off after some time. Okay. I will press and release immediately. Yes. Okay. I just increase the delay. See, once you make any change in the program, let me come back to the program. Once you make any change, see, now I increase this delay by including 100 here. Then what you should do is you should go to the MCU and build it again. Every time you need to take care of this building. Okay. Once you build it, come back to the circuit, then run the program. Okay, so I am just pressing switch. Now you can see the delay is more. I release the switch, but still it is on, right? It was too much delay. Yeah. Once again, I will switch on the LED and off. And you can see it is still on. Okay, so we have done one part of the program, that is when the switch is pressed, the LED is on and it will be off after some time. So just by changing the delay, you can just change this, how much time it should be on. And what do we do to make sure that it is only on as long as the key switch is pressed? To do that, you should just remove the delay part, so it will be in real time. So I will stop this, come back here and take out this delay from this program and save it. Go to MCU, build it. Okay, then go to the circuit. Let us see whether it will work or not. Run it. and I am pressing the switch. The moment I release the switch, it is off. So there is no delay. So there are two cases, right? The first case is only when the switch is pressed, LED is on. When the switch is released, LED is off. The second case, even after the switch is released, it will be on after sundown. So this is the second experiment we can see here. That's all about the program. And you know, you have seen the program, how it works. And here we are using directly the inbuilt setup of this multisim itself to write this program. So hope you understood the circuit, how it works and all. So yeah, that's it. Thank you.